Have you ever found yourself wondering which is better between yoga and Pilates? Well, you're not alone. These two forms of exercise have taken the fitness world by storm, each offering unique benefits. Today, we're going to delve into the world of yoga and Pilates, comparing their histories, methodologies, and benefits. We'll also discuss some common misconceptions and help you decide which one might be the better fit for you. So let's dive in and explore these two popular forms of exercise. Scene script. First, let's discuss yoga. But what exactly is yoga? Yoga, a term derived from the Sanskrit word yuj, means to unite or to join. Originating over 5,000 years ago in India, yoga is more than just a form of exercise. It's a philosophy, a science, and an art of living that aims to unite the mind, the body, and the spirit. There are several types of yoga, each with its unique focus and benefits. Hatha yoga, for instance, is excellent for beginners as it focuses on basic postures and slow-paced stretching, while Ashtanga yoga, known for its rigorous sequence of postures, is great for building core strength and toning the body. Then there's Kundalini yoga, which combines dynamic breathing, meditation, and the chanting of mantras to awaken the energy at the base of the spine. And let's not forget about restorative yoga, a relaxing style that uses props to support the body, allowing you to completely let go and relax. But no matter the style, the main objectives of yoga remain the same: to promote physical health, mental clarity, emotional balance, and spiritual growth. Yoga's benefits are manifold. It can help relieve stress, improve flexibility, build strength, and enhance balance. It's not just about bending and twisting, but about breathing and being. So, yoga is a holistic approach that focuses on both the mind and the body. Now let's move on to Pilates. But what exactly is Pilates? Pilates is a physical fitness system that was developed in the early 20th century by Joseph Pilates, hence the name. It was originally called contrology, reflecting its focus on the mind's control over the body. Joseph Pilates believed that mental and physical health were interconnected, a philosophy that remains at the heart of Pilates today. The main objective of Pilates is to strengthen the body, with a particular emphasis on core strength. This focus on the core, the powerhouse of the body, is what sets Pilates apart from other forms of exercise. It's not just about getting a six-pack, though. A strong core can improve your posture, reduce back pain, and even enhance your performance in other sports. There are two main types of Pilates: mat Pilates and reformer Pilates. Mat Pilates is performed on, you guessed it, a mat, just like in yoga. Reformer Pilates, on the other hand, uses a special machine to provide resistance, making the exercises more challenging. But the benefits of Pilates go beyond just physical fitness. Regular practice can increase flexibility, improve balance, and promote a sense of calm and well-being. It's also a great method for injury prevention and rehabilitation, thanks to its low-impact nature and focus on controlled movements. So, Pilates is a method of exercise that focuses on strengthening the body, particularly the core. Now that we know what yoga and Pilates are, let's discuss the differences between the two. Firstly, the focus of the exercises in yoga and Pilates differ. Yoga is all about harmonizing the mind, body, and spirit. It focuses on flexibility, balance, and strength, and is deeply rooted in spirituality. Each pose is held for a few breaths, promoting mindfulness and relaxation. Yoga encourages internal focus, meditation, and deep breathing. On the other hand, Pilates is a physical fitness system developed in the early 20th century by Joseph Pilates. It focuses on core strength, flexibility, and overall body awareness. Unlike yoga, Pilates does not incorporate spirituality into its practice. Instead, it emphasizes precise movements to target specific muscle groups, with an emphasis on the powerhouse, your abs, lower back, and glutes. Secondly, the equipment used in both also varies significantly. Yoga can be practiced with minimal equipment. A yoga mat is typically all you need, though some people may use props like blocks and straps to help with alignment and balance. Pilates, however, often requires specialized equipment such as the reformer, a machine with a sliding carriage and adjustable springs to control tension and resistance. Pilates can also be done on a mat, but the repertoire of exercises is different from those done on machines. Lastly, the intensity of the workouts differs between the two. Yoga can be as gentle or as challenging as you want it to be, with different styles ranging from restorative to power yoga. Pilates tends to be more intense, with a focus on small, controlled movements that require strength and stability. It's a full-body workout that can be modified to suit different fitness levels, but it's generally more physically demanding than most forms of yoga. In summary, while yoga and Pilates have some similarities, they also have distinct differences that make each unique. Yoga offers a holistic approach, enhancing mindfulness, flexibility, and strength. Pilates, on the other hand, provides a more targeted, intensive workout with a focus on core strength and body awareness. Thus, the choice between the two depends on your personal goals and preferences. So, the burning question, which is better, yoga or Pilates? Well, it's not a simple answer, because it truly depends on what you're looking to get out of your workout. They both have their strengths and can provide a range of benefits, but let's dig a little deeper. If your fitness goal is to increase your flexibility and relieve stress, yoga might be your go-to. Yoga poses stretch your muscles and increase your range of motion, and with practice, they can help improve your flexibility. But the benefits aren't just physical. Yoga also encourages relaxation and can help reduce stress. It involves a lot of meditation and deep breathing, which can be beneficial for those who are looking to find some calm in their busy lives. On the other hand, if your goal is to strengthen your core and improve your posture, Pilates could be the one for you. Pilates exercises focus on your core strength. It's all about control and precision, with a strong emphasis on technique and proper form. It can help you develop a strong, balanced body and improve your posture by strengthening your back and abdominal muscles. So if you're looking to tone up and stand a little taller, Pilates might be your best bet. But let's not forget, it's not a one-size-fits-all situation. You might find that a combination of both yoga and Pilates works best for you, giving you the best of both worlds. You could focus on your flexibility and stress relief with yoga, and then work on your core strength and posture with Pilates. Ultimately, the decision between yoga and Pilates comes down to your personal fitness goals and what you want to achieve. You might even decide to switch between the two depending on your mood, your energy level, or even the day of the week. So whether yoga or Pilates is better for you depends on your personal fitness goals. Choose the workout that aligns with your objectives, and remember, the best workout is the one that you enjoy and stick with. So, we've learned a lot about yoga and Pilates today, but let's wrap things up. In the past 10 minutes, we've delved into the complex worlds of yoga and Pilates, unearthing the unique benefits each practice brings. We've discovered that both yoga and Pilates are more than just physical exercises. They're holistic practices that intertwine the body, mind, and spirit. We started by exploring yoga, an ancient practice with roots in Indian philosophy. Yoga is all about balance, flexibility, and inner peace. It's a practice that encourages mindfulness and deep, focused breathing. Yoga is versatile, with many different styles, from the peaceful and meditative Hatha yoga to the more intense and physically demanding Ashtanga yoga. Then we ventured into the world of Pilates, a comparatively younger discipline developed in the early 20th century by Joseph Pilates. Pilates focuses on core strength, overall body conditioning, and improved posture. Unlike yoga, Pilates is more structured and has a strong emphasis on technique and precision. It's a great choice for those looking to tone their muscles and strengthen their bodies. We then compared the two, highlighting the differences. While both practices promote strength, flexibility, and mindfulness, they approach these goals from different angles. Yoga is more spiritual and meditative, focusing on the connection between mind, body, and spirit. On the other hand, Pilates is more physical and structured, emphasizing core strength and body conditioning. But the question remains, which is better, yoga or Pilates? The answer is not as straightforward as you might think. Both practices have their unique strengths, and what works best for you depends on your personal goals, needs, and preferences. If you're seeking inner peace and flexibility, yoga might be your go-to. But if you're after core strength and body conditioning, Pilates could be the better choice. We encourage you to try both practices. Experience the calming breathwork and poses of yoga, and the precise, strengthening exercises of Pilates. Listen to your body and see which practice resonates with you more. There's no one-size-fits-all when it comes to fitness. It's all about finding what works for you and what you enjoy. Remember, the best exercise is the one you enjoy and will stick with. So give both yoga and Pilates a try and see which one you prefer. Thanks for watching.